My dear friends, in my last video I discussed about the term preamble, and today in this video I am going to discuss what are the components or what are the ingredients of the preamble. And those students who did not watch my last video, for them link is given in my description box. Please watch this video because it will be helpful for you. So before starting the video, I would like to introduce myself first. My name is Rajdeep. I read in BA third semester, and welcome to everyone in my YouTube channel Political Study. And it's my request to everyone, please subscribe my channel so that relevant videos relating to political science will be available to all of you. So let's come to the point. What are the components or what are the ingredients of the preamble, right? So before starting further explanation, today in this video again I am going to give you a small introduction about the term preamble, because those students who did not watch my last video, for them it will be very very much helpful. Okay, so what is the meaning of the word preamble, or what is the meaning of the term preamble? See, in a very simple way, the term preamble means that it is the introduction or preface of the constitution. It contains the summary and essence of the constitution. Now what is the meaning of the word essence? What is the meaning of the word essence? Essence means nature, that what should be the nature of our Indian constitution. And my dear friend, the word essence itself signifies that what is the importance of preamble in our Indian constitution. For example, you can say that preamble is the gateway of our Indian constitution. Preamble is the base of our Indian constitution. Preamble is the foundation of our Indian constitution. So you can imagine that what is the importance of preamble in our Indian constitution. Now the preamble of our Indian constitution is based on this objective resolution. The preamble of our Indian constitution is based on this objective resolution. Now what is objective resolution? See, objective resolution was drafted by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru in the year 13 December 1946, and it was accepted by the Constituent Assembly in the year 22 January 1947. So the term preamble, or the term preamble of our Indian constitution, is based on this objective resolution, and this objective resolution is known as what? The preamble of our Indian constitution. Now my dear friends, there are two questions, and our first question is that do you think that preamble is a part of our Indian constitution? Then yes, preamble is a part of our Indian constitution, because after the judgment of Kesavinanda Bharati case in the year 1976, the Supreme Court says, or the Supreme Court accept that preamble is a part of our Indian constitution. Now our second question is that do you think that preamble can be amended? Then yes, preamble can be amended under article, remember this article, okay, under article 368, under article 368 of our Indian constitution, preamble can be amended. But the basic structure, the base or the foundation of the preamble cannot be amended. Now what is 42 second amendment act 1976? See, this 42 second amendment act 1976 is also known as mini constitution. Is also known as what? Mini constitution. It is also known as what? Mini constitution, because through this amendment act 1976, many changes took place in our Indian constitution. And that's why it is also known as what? Mini constitution. And through this amendment act 1976, three new words added in the term preamble, that is socialist, secular and integrity. So these are the three words that added in the preamble through this 42nd Amendment Act 1976. So this is a very small introduction of the term preamble. Now let's move to our main topic, and our main topic is that what are the components or what are the ingredients of the preamble, right? What are the components or what are the ingredients of the preamble? So our first point is source of authority of our Indian Constitution. Now, what is the meaning of source of authority of our Indian Constitution? It means that from where the Constitution of India derives its authority, right? Now, see, in the keywords of the preamble, in the first line, it is very, very clearly mentioned, we the people of India. And it indicates in the preamble that the source of authority of our Indian Constitution lies with the people of India. And my dear friends, if the question comes that what is the source of authority of our Indian Constitution, then without wasting your time, just write it down that the source of authority of our Indian Constitution lies with the people of India, or the Constitution of India derives its authority from the people of India. Clear? Now, let's move to our next point. And our next point is nature of Indian state. See, the preamble declares that India to be a sovereign, socialist, secular and democratic republic. Now, our first topic is sovereign. What is the meaning of the term sovereign? See, the term sovereign means that India has its own independent authority, and there is not a domination of any other country or any external power. And in India, there is a legislature, and the legislature has the power to make laws for the people of India. Now, before India independence, that is before 1947, India was not a sovereign country, because Britishers made laws for India or for the people of India, and all the important decisions were taken by the British government. That means what? That means Britishers dominated India. Britishers dominated the people of India. So before India independence, India was not a sovereign country. But after India independence, that is after 1947. Now see another thing. When the Constitution of India came into force? The Constitution of India came into force in the year 26 January 1950. The Constitution of India came into force in the year 26 January 1950. And after the Constitution of India came into force, India has become a sovereign country, because India has its own government and there is no domination of any other country or any external powers. That means India is a sovereign country. Understand? Now, let's move to our next topic. And our next topic is socialist. Now, what is the meaning of the term socialist? See, the term socialist means the achievement of socialist ends through democratic means, and it holds faith in mixed economy where both private and public sector coexist side by side. And my dear friends, as the Supreme Court says, that the democratic socialism aims to end poverty, ignorance, disease and inequality of opportunity. And the term socialist added in the preamble by the 42nd Amendment Act 1976. Clear? Now, let's move to our third topic, and our third topic is secular. So I think every one of you have a little bit idea about the meaning of the term secular, right? So what is the meaning of the term secular? Secular means what? Secular means every religion in India should get equal right, equal opportunity, equal protection and equal support from the state. And this is a very, very simple meaning of the term secular. And my dear friends, the term secular is also added in our Indian in the preamble by the 42nd Amendment Act 1976. Understand?
So now our fourth topic is democratic. What is the meaning of the term democratic? See, the term democratic is based on the system of democracy. Now, what is the meaning of the term democracy? See, democracy means it is a system in which the government of a country is elected by the people through what? Through election. Now, see, there are two types of democracy. One is direct democracy and the other is indirect democracy. Direct democracy means what? Direct democracy means where people directly participating in government decision making. On the other hand, indirect democracy means where people elect their representatives like MPs and MLAs to act and take decision on behalf of these people. Now see, the term democratic implies that the Constitution of India has an established form of constitution in which the government derives its authority from the will of the people through what? Through election. This is the meaning of the term democratic. Understand? My dear friends, our fifth topic is republic. Our fifth topic is republic. Now, what is the meaning of the term republic? See, a democratic polity can be classified into two categories. One is monarchy and the other is republic. Monarchy means the head of the state, usually kings or queens, enjoy the hereditary position. On the other hand, republic means the head of the state is elected directly or indirectly for a fixed period of time. For example, USA. Now see, the term republic in our preamble indicates that India has an elected head called the president. And he is elected indirectly for a fixed period of 5 years. And this is the meaning of the term republic. Now see, suppose if anyone asks you a question that tell me what are the nature of an Indian state. So just answer it that preamble declares that India to be a sovereign, socialist, secular and democratic republic. Clear? Now, let's move to our third point, and our third point is objective of our Indian constitution. Our third point is what? Objective of our Indian constitution. And my dear friends, the main objective of our Indian constitution is to promote harmony throughout the nation. And the main objective of our Indian constitution are justice, equality, liberty, and fraternity. Now, first of all, justice. See, there are three types of justice. Justice divided into three types. One is social justice. Number two, political justice. And number three, economic justice. Justice divided into three parts. One is social justice, another is political justice, and the third is economic justice. Now, what is social justice? See, social justice means equal opportunity, and there should be no any kind of discrimination on the basis of caste, class, religion, gender, etc. And in a very simple way, you can say social justice means absence of discrimination and presence of equal opportunity. This is the meaning of social justice. Now, political justice. Political justice means what? Political justice means right to vote, right to contest election, right to criticize the government. And political justice can be enjoyed in a democracy. This is the meaning of political justice. So now, what is economic justice? What is the meaning of economic justice? See, economic justice means no discrimination can be caused by the people on the basis of what? On the basis of wealth, income and economic status, and every people should get the opportunity to earn for their living, and this is the meaning of economic justice. So our next topic is equality. What is the meaning of the term equality? See, equality means that everyone should get equal opportunity, and there should not be any kind of discrimination on the basis of caste, class, religion, gender, etc. That means everyone should get equal opportunity for their self-development. It means having same rights, privileges, status and opportunities. But however, equality does not mean that all are to be treated equally in all circumstances. And if you want to know in brief, then link is given in my description box. You can watch this video because it may be helpful for you. And this is the meaning of the term equality. Now, my dear friends, our third topic is liberty. Our third topic is what? Liberty. Now, what is the meaning of the term liberty? See, liberty means that freedom for the people to choose their way of life. Freedom for the people to choose their way of life. But liberty does not mean that you can do anything on your wish. A person can do anything, but in limits set by the law. This is the meaning of the term liberty. Clear? So now our fourth topic is fraternity. What is the meaning of the term fraternity? See, fraternity means a feeling brotherhood or an emotional attachment with the country and all the people. And my dear friends, fraternity helps to promote dignity and unity throughout the nation. And this is the very simple meaning of the term fraternity. Now, what are the objective of our Indian constitution? The objective of our Indian constitution are justice, equality, liberty and fraternity. These are the objectives of our Indian constitution. Now, our fourth point is date of adoption of our Indian constitution. Now see, there is a confusion. Many students get confused between date of adoption and when the constitution of India came into force. So let me clear you that the constitution of India was adopted in the year 26 November 1949. The constitution of India was adopted in the year 26 November 1949. And when the constitution of India came into force, the constitution of India came into force in the year 26 January 1950. Okay, the constitution of India was adopted in the year 26 November 1949, and the constitution of India came into force in the year 26 January 1950. Okay, so these are the components and ingredients of the preamble. So I think that this video is helpful for all of you. And if you like my today's video, please click on the like icon. And if you have any doubt regarding this topic, you can comment me in my comment section. And don't forget to share this video with your friends. And please follow me on my Instagram ID. For today, I have finished here.